Hey, it's me, your favorite artist you obviously subscribe to, and I heard that you're looking to become a digital artist. But there is one small problem. You have no idea what you need to begin drawing. This tutorial is for those who want to begin drawing digitally but simply don't really know what the best stuff on the market is. And my job today is to inform you and help you pick what you need based on your budget and environment. Also, just so you know, this video is not sponsored or anything, so most of this is based on my experiences and research. Getting started on digital art is pretty easy. There are legit only three, maybe two things you need to get started. Number one, a drawing tablet, of course. Number two, art software. And number three, a computer. And that might be based on what kind of drawing tablet you're getting, but we'll get into that later. So in today's video, we're gonna review over some different drawing tablets and softwares that you can possibly get. So the first thing you, of course, need to think about is what drawing tablet you need. And there are a lot of choices you can pick. So let's narrow it down based on three factors. Number one, what is your budget? With a lower budget of maybe below $100, you can probably afford some decent non-screen tablets. With a medium budget consisting around $200 to $500, there are some good screen tablets that should be pretty consistent. And with high budgets above $500, that of course lets you get some professional equipment. And just remember that your budget does not hold your improvement back. Just because you may have a non-screen tablet doesn't mean you won't be able to improve as fast as if you had a screen tablet. What tablet you have does not dictate your skill level. Okay, on to our next factor. Number two, do you already own a functioning computer or laptop? A lot of drawing tablets require a computer to draw, and there are very few options that are a computer on their own. If you plan on getting something like a non-screen tablet, you'll need a pre-existing computer that is not on its last breath. This may also affect your budget because if you have a low budget and you don't own a computer, you may not be able to afford both a tablet and computer. And our last factor, do you need to bring your tablet to a lot of places? Portability may be important to you if you like drawing in school or if you're moving a lot around your house. If you like to have all your shit on the desk though, you can probably get away with a beefier tablet. With those three factors in mind, let's get into some popular tablets that should cater to a lot of people. The first tablet we'll talk about is one everyone knows about, the iPad. If you don't own a computer and you have a medium-ranged budget, then the iPad will be perfect for you. The iPad is probably one of the most consistent tablets. Most other tablets sometimes malfunction and you have to restart your whole computer just to fix it, but the iPad on the other hand encounters some of the least amount of glitches and it is really actually reliable. The budget is also very flexible since there are so many models of the iPad. If you have a low medium budget, you can probably get the regular iPad which goes for about $329 plus the Pencil which is about $100, which is much cheaper than buying a computer and a tablet. If you have a higher budget on the other hand, you can get the iPad Pro which is $800 plus the second generation Apple Pencil which is $130. You can probably find it for cheaper too if you look for pre-owned ones on eBay or, you know, at a garage sale, who knows. Though the iPad doesn't come without its merits. One of the biggest cons is that Apple has a closed market, meaning you won't be able to get most of the applications we'll be talking about later, such as Paint Tool Sai and Photoshop. Although there is an application that I will touch on later. Second, if you already own a computer, then the investment in the iPad is probably more than a cheaper drawing tablet. Other than that, if you have enough money and you don't really want to invest in a decent laptop, then this is probably one of the best options out there. The $60 tablet won by Wacom is a perfect mix between budget and quality. Between all of Wacom's small non-screen tablets, you'll get the most bang for your buck from this one, and that is if you already own a decent computer though. Wacom has always been known for its quality stuff, so you can probably expect this tablet to last you a while. I really recommend this one if you still don't really know whether or not you'll enjoy digital art, so this was pretty good to get a little taste of how it'll feel. However, the biggest downside may be its size and lack of shortcut buttons. This thing is like 8x5 inches and doesn't really provide that much active area. Shortcut buttons were also kind of sacrificed to increase that area as well, but you can always just use your keyboard as an easy replacement. Also, it doesn't have a touchpad, so it'll just be your pen that'll work with it. Overall, this is a really great beginner tablet for those looking to see what digital art feels like. If you want to go cheaper than $60 though, I'll do $40. Behold, the XP Pen Star G6440, holy shit the name. Probably the cheapest drawing tablet that won't catch on fire. You're literally buying the bare minimum, so it's gonna be small at a 6x4 active area. Also, it's literally 2 millimeters in thickness, so I have no idea if that'll be good for portability or if it's as fragile as a cookie. However, it claims to have more of a resolution and pressure sensitivity than the One by Wacom, so I mean, if that seems really impressive to you, then this is probably the better option. Reading the reviews though, a lot of people have had positive experiences with the tablet. Some even call it better than the Wacom Intuos Pro tablet. So if you want to try digital art and you have at most $40, then this one's a good one to start on. Don't worry, this is the only other Wacom tablet we'll talk about. The Wacom One, not to get it mixed up with the One by Wacom, is a screen tablet that is probably the cheapest one that Wacom sells, which is priced at $400. This is specifically made for beginners, so it is a pretty good starting tablet. It has a 13.3 inches HD display, which in my opinion is perfect since every screen tablet I've owned has always been that size. If you want bigger tablets though, just look at the Cintiq series. It is literally the Wacom One tablet but bigger, and I have no idea why they took away all the shortcut buttons on the side. Why did you do this? Also, the matte screen that it has feels super good. That's probably the only reason I like Wacom products. I hate glossy screens that other manufacturers have. Once again, the downside is that it has no shortcut buttons, and it's not portable since you need to have it connected to a PC for it to work. Plus, it has to be connected to an outlet. Overall, this tablet may not be portable, but it offers a really good price for computer users. The cheapest screen tablet you can probably get that won't explode though is the Huon Canvas Pro 13. Unlike the Wacom One, this one does come with shortcut keys and it's also as big as it with a 13.3 inch screen. However, from reading the reviews, it does have some inconsistencies. It has some calibration problems towards the edges, which I have experienced before, and when drawing slowly, there are some line jitters, which I can imagine is pretty annoying. But what can you really expect from the cheapest functioning screen tablet out there? If you decide to get this tablet, be sure to read the reviews to make sure you know what you're getting into. Lastly, there are a lot of wires to this tablet, so don't expect any portability. The Huon Canvas Pro 13 is still $300, and that might not really seem cheap to a lot of people, but this was the cheapest functioning screen tablet I could find that didn't break right out of the box. If you need to go cheaper than this, I would just recommend getting a non-screen tablet. So yeah, if you didn't like my recommendations or you didn't find something that catered to your need, then here are some of the best drawing tablet producers, just so you know where to at least look. My preference is Wacom, but to be honest, it's pretty much the Apple of the drawing tablet market. It's reliable and stable, but overpriced at times. If you're on a budget, just check out the other manufacturers. Alright, now that you have a drawing tablet and maybe a computer, let's go over some of the most popular drawing softwares. Anyone other than iPad users can probably skip this one since it's only available in the App Store. Procreate. Procreate is regarded as one of the best drawing softwares ever. It's pretty much the Photoshop of the Apple Store. Procreate has some of the most polished interfaces while also containing a high amount of complexity, so beginners won't have trouble figuring it out while the veterans can still use it to its limit. It also supports a shitload of brushes and custom brushes, so you won't be stuck with some simple-ass shapes. If you need a leaf brush, you can probably import it. One of my favorite features though is that it records your drawings, so you can create time lapses without having to do anything or record anything. It's only $10, so you don't have to pay Photoshop prices for a simple app. So if you have an iPad, this one's pretty much a given. There's nothing really on the App Store that can contest this app. Now we can get onto the computer apps. The first one we're going to talk about is Clip Studio Paint. This is the software that I currently use, and there are two versions of it that you can purchase based on what you're looking for. Pro is $50, and it's pretty much only for illustrations and nothing else. If you're looking to do advanced comics, manga, or animation, then you'll have to pay $220, but that's only if you're looking to do that. If you just want to draw, then you can just buy a Pro. It has a demo too if you want to try it out, so you don't really have to worry about having to buy it right away. And this app is on iPad, but it's not as good, and you have to pay monthly, which is kind of stinky. Clip Studio Paint though is perfect for those who want to draw anime or cartoony stuff since it has a decent brush engine, which feels good, and it has a lot of advanced tools such as rulers, which is useful for symmetry or perspectives, 3D models, which you can use to draw over as a base to help you practice anatomy, and text support, which you can use to make comics. There are a lot of features that every artist will love, but the sad thing is that the interface is pretty intimidating. Configuring brushes is probably scarier than SCP-3001. But don't worry, CSP also offers a brush marketplace. There is a lot of cool shit on here, so you can download some brushes other artists make if you don't know how to make your own. As you get used to it though, you'll understand more how to use it. CSP is pretty much catered to those who wish to draw anime and shit, so yeah, I check it out. The next app we'll be talking about is PaintTool Sai. PaintTool Sai is probably one of the simplest art programs. It's super stable, and maybe the best thing about the program is the brush engine. I don't know what they did, but it's so fucking smooth. I swear to God, it's better than real life. Although the biggest caveat is that it legit doesn't have any tools you would expect other programs to have, such as rulers, text, and you can't use the selection tool on more than one layer, which is sad. Also, if you want to import custom brushes, you gotta do this whole file manipulation shit, and it's too complicated if you're not really a computer techie person. Lastly, there's like 10 blending layers, which kind of sucks too, but it's the only ones that matter, so it's not that bad. I know I made it sound like shit, but I really actually recommend this program if you enjoy digitally painting or if you don't really like the complexity of other art programs. It's also $50, but luckily there is a demo. Now we're gonna have a free option, Metabang. Metabang is a really good free application if you don't really have the money to spend. It's available on PC, iPad, iPhone, and Android. It's marketed towards anime and cartoon art style, so it's kind of like Clip Studio Paint. And honestly, I would just say that this application is pretty much just a free version of CSP, but the brush blending engine is kind of worse. I don't know if that's because the last time I used it was like 2017 when I didn't really know how to draw that well, but the stabilization when drawing your lines though feels really nice. Probably the better free software available. It also includes a lot of cool tools like text rulers, cool ass brushes. It also supports comic and manga creation, but it doesn't have any animation features. If you're looking to not spend any money, then Metabang is actually really good. And the last drawing software we're going to talk about is Photoshop. Now, in my opinion, I don't really like Photoshop, but I'd say its biggest pro is probably its brush engine. I'd say it's second best to PaintTool Sai, but it's way easier to import brushes from other artists. Although most of the brushes are for realistic painting, and I don't really see a lot of brushes offered to those who wish to do like cartoony anime stuff. So I'd say if you really like drawing realism or you like drawing landscapes and stuff like that, I would recommend Photoshop. Photoshop is also super duper good for like graphic design. So let's say you have like a picture of your character and you kind of want to make merchandise or t-shirts with them or something like that, then I also recommend Photoshop for that. The worst thing about it though is the way you buy it. The thing is, you don't. You have to pay a certain amount monthly to use it, which a lot of young artists can't really do. So I only recommend Photoshop if you're a realistic digital artist that can legally own a debit card and has a job. So yeah, those are probably the best drawing softwares that I could recommend to you because I've personally had really good experience with all of them. So you see, to get started in digital art, all you really need is a drawing tablet, a computer that can actually run, but that's only if you didn't choose an iPad, and a drawing software, and you're ready to go. So if you're a traditional artist transitioning to digital art, then I wish you good luck because it's actually really fun. And I hope this tutorial did teach you something about where to search and stuff, and I hope I was able to help you. So yeah, that concludes our tutorial, and I will see you next week. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share this video to whatever newbie you stumble upon. So yeah.